Sunday evening, in fact,
yes,
it is.
We are. Let me just see if we get
Sunday
the light on us.
Sunday evening.
Yes. So you can maybe see behind us.
We are going to the Plaza.
Plaza and Crosby, picture house. The old picture house. The Flicks.
The cinema.
Go on the Flicks.
Cinema. Not flicky pictures anymore, Colin. Come on, get with it.
So, we can't show you what's like. Well, we can show you what's like inside, but we can't show you the film.
No.
Hopefully, going to show you what's like inside.
Yeah,
if they let us.
Yeah.
Won't see Cruella. See you inside. Life could be a dream.
Looking at both at the moment. If I could take you up in paradise up above, wouldn't you tell me I'm the only one that you love? Life would be a dream, sweetheart. Hello, hello again.
Yeah. A couple of coffees down here. Nice posters.
Yeah,
nice posters. Lights. It's brilliant, isn't it?
Lovely, isn't it? Yeah. Give us them coffees.
Give us them.
You got it?
Yeah, come on. I'm just thinking. This might see better in this light. And it's a push open. That's echo. More posters there. James Hadley, Barbara Stanwyck.
More along.
That's it, like it.
Is that a classic,
it is to some people, isn't it? I will now, just going to see. The mirror's all nice.
That's nice, isn't it?
That's echo mirror.
Could you have a dressing table mirror like that?
Mary Poppins.
Right.
Step inside. As you come further down these steps, there's even more posters. Classic, psycho. Sounds really nice. Nintendo Mona pictures, come here guys, if you're anywhere to look near the group. It's well worth it.
Yeah. It's
beautiful, it's an adventure.
Yeah.
Just come on and look. Sounds of music. There's a picture there.
They're from the outside.
Yeah.
Incidentally, Colin has his name in lights. Didn't you?
On here, yeah.
On here. Last birthday.
Yeah.
Special birthday, and I got his name in lights.
We drove past, and we found the footage with the NCAA team. Funny little bit of footage, because we were driving past at the time.
And I had to say, Colin, go back, because he missed it. Go back and see. I need you to see it all of a sudden.
From the very beginning, I realized I saw the world differently than everyone else. That didn't sit well with some people. But I wasn't for everyone. I guess they were always scared that I'd be a psycho.
Sorry now.
But a new day brings new opportunities. And I was ready to make a statement. How does the saying go? I am woman, hear me roar. I'm just getting started, darling. Thing is, I was born brilliant, born bad, and a little bit mad.
See what he can tell us. Come with us. Come on, there's a little fact here for you. Yeah, I did wonder if you were going to say when I seen it 1939. Yeah, then it opened. So the bars are open but closed for one day. Pretty inconvenient.
It's a bit of bad luck, wasn't it? Hi guys, inside in the Plaza at the moment, speaking to Martin Fol. No, Martin from a long time back, and he knows Tracy's
dad.
Okay, Dad.
He's just formal, you know, isn't he?
Knows Tracy's dad, yeah. From Royal Mail. And he's just spinning around. Let's see. Hiya, Martin.
Afternoon.
It is afternoon, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, how long have you been here, Martin?
So I started in January 1999, and how that come about was, I got married in 1998, and I live in Crosby anyway, so I've always come here as a kid. And my mum died in the January of 1999,
yeah.
And so I wanted to do something in the afternoon, because when I was in Rome, I had finished at 1 o'clock, so I decided to come here and just ask Janet Dunn, who was the chair of the trustees, and she was also a duty manager at the time. Yeah. And I asked her, is there any volunteers going? She said, yeah. So I became a volunteer, got my wife involved as well.
Yeah.
Little did I know, I wouldn't be working in the afternoons, yeah, or tea times. I'd be working in the evenings.
Yeah.
And when you work in the evenings, when you work for Roma, you have to go up at 4:30 the following,
yeah,
morning.
That's right, yeah.
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 I used to do 2 days a week, so Tuesday and a Friday, and then I cut it down to one.
Yeah.
And then I left Roma in 2011, I took voluntary redundancy, and yeah, then I was already the actual co-manager here then at the time,
yeah,
unpaid, and then I became the manager in 2011, unpaid for a couple of years, and then they decided to ask me, would I take on the job as a paid manager, which,
yeah,
obviously I did,
yeah.
Yeah.
And I've been the manager here now for 10 years.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Lovely. Cool.
Good, yeah.
I mean, as you say, we came here, as you see in the footage,
yeah,
to watch Cruella.
Couple of days ago.
It's been a long time since I've been here. It's been many, many years since I've last
and
been
I've
here.
I've never been here, so I was really impressed.
And it's a lovely cinema, as you can see.
Yeah, it's an art deco modern cinema built in 1939.
Yeah.
It's 82 years old this year. Open and closed on the first day.
Just read that on the floor, didn't
you
see that the other day? Yeah.
On the 2nd of September, open and closed on the first day of
What a thing to happen, like, you know, when you just build a new cinema and opens up and then close the first day.
So
we just paused there for a moment, guys, just might have to go and see to something. Where were we up to? You were telling us all about how you came to
the cinema. Yeah, so I obviously got involved and I've been here for 22 years now. The cinema itself opened on the 2nd of September 1939,
yeah,
and due to the outbreak of the Second World War, closed on the same day.
Yeah.
It's the only cinema in the whole of the world. In the Guinness Book of Records, that opened and closed on its first day.
Yeah.
And the first film that we showed was called South Riding.
Yeah.
And the poster for that film, original poster, is downstairs in the foyer on the wall.
Yeah.
So as you go out, you'll see it on the wall.
Yeah.
It's on the wall there. It wasn't put up until a few weeks ago. We've had it in here for ages in this room. And we moved the pitch that was there to the other side of the room. So we've got three screens.
Yeah.
Has it always had three screens?
No, it's always been one screen, 1,400 people,
wow,
in the big screen, upstairs and down. And then in 1974 it became a multiplex, so it became the first multiplex on Merseyside, so it's got two smaller screens, they're both 92 seaters.
Yeah.
So screen 2 and screen 3, 92 seaters. Screen 1 now has a maximum of 596. Which is 216 seats downstairs and 380 seats upstairs, which are the original seats from 1939,
wow,
all refurbished about 3 or 4 years ago. Due to social distancing, the numbers are drastically reduced from 92 to 44 on the smaller screens, and from 596 to 232 in the big screen.
Yeah.
And that all depends on people buying tickets, because once you buy two tickets, you block out two seats.
That's
six as well.
We did see that.
All the measures are all in place, and all the
which
safety measures are in place.
You want to see
And we've been like that since we reopened in July of last year. Because we were closed from March to the end of July, and then we went from July to November, and then we closed all of November and opened in December, and closed again on the 30th of December.
Jeez.
And reopened on the 19th of May, which is only just recently. So we've had loads of spells where we've gone from 166,000 people in 2019 coming through the doors. In 2010, only 54,000 people came through the doors.
Yeah.
So we moved that massively up the scale.
Yeah.
But obviously 2020, only 45,000 people came through the doors.
Oh.
So the impact on the cinema has been quite drastic. We're still in.
Yeah.
It's good that you're still in.
But you can't wait to get back to normality.
Oh, I wish we'd have some form of normality, because we never used to have online booking here. Never had online booking, and we've got online booking, and it is a bit of a sort of a nightmare, or can be,
because
people book. And then they don't realise what they've booked.
And
then we have people, we have allocated seats.
Yeah.
So they pick their own seats, but when you go upstairs, we don't allocate them anymore, because the area is so vast to clean upstairs.
Yeah.
It takes a lot longer than downstairs. So we'd taken out the allocated seating, and hence why I just disappeared. Because I was making sure people were sitting on the lower part of the balcony so we can concentrate on that area to clean rather than do the whole of the screen.
Do you know what I thought it was? Because we tried to move the balcony, didn't we?
Yeah.
And I thought it was in case anybody was sneezing or coughing. And
what it is, the balcony is only used when we're full downstairs. So on a normal day, under normal circumstances, downstairs wouldn't be full. So we wouldn't use upstairs. But because of social distancing, 96 seats downstairs, which are 216, just goes because people come in ones and twos and strip out all the seats. Yeah. So then we open upstairs, albeit we wait for downstairs to be sold. But when under normal circumstances we wouldn't, so for example, Sunday, Quiet Place is just released today officially. I've been wanting to see that for over a year now, and I'm coming in to see with my colleague to watch it, and hopefully no one will be upstairs, never <everyone's> downstairs. Like last time when they're all downstairs, all quiet, no one spoke, no one sneezed, no one coughed, and this time we'll have to open upstairs.
Shame.
It's a good film, the first one. I
watched it. Really good. The second one, I believe, is really good as well.
So I want to see that myself.
We're going to come see that.
The prices are really good.
Our prices have remained the same for the last 10 years. They're £3.90 for children and concessions and £4.90 for adults,
as opposed to
multiplexes, which are currently reduced prices but will go back up to their £13 and £14, I'm sure.
So anybody looking to go to pictures, come to the Plaza.
It's all about affordability. The ethos of the Plaza is about affordability. It's not about making money. All the money we get gets invested back in just getting the wall done in the car park. Everything's done, and the seats are getting refurbished. We've had loads of stuff getting done, loads of painting done. Carpets have been renewed, logos have been put in on the carpets. So it's all the money goes back in. We don't have shareholders or anything like that. Multiplexes are run by organisations with shareholders.
Do you have a charity shop as well?
We've got a charity shop, which is run by Colette and Hannah. That's in 89 St John's Road, which is just a few hundred yards down that way towards Crosby, and they sell saleable goods. They've been going since 1996, and they have raised so far about £830,000.
Brilliant.
In 20 odd years.
So if anyone's got anything,
and you've got anything that's they'll take clothes, and if you can't sell them, they'll salvage them, and they'll take bric-a-brac, and they'll take furniture, and it's in St John's Road, 89 St John's Road.
So it's a good community.
That started about 4 weeks, took over as the cinema.
We'll leave the address, guys, in the descriptions down below, so if anybody wants to go and donate anything, you can do so.
Is there a food bank as well? That's
my baby, the food bank. Because obviously, I work for Royal Mail, obviously, and I'm now the manager here. I wanted to link in with the local community to have partnerships with a lot of people, schools and different people. Obviously, I'm a school governor in the locality as well, so I linked into the food bank. So what we do is we get people on special events to bring loads of stuff in, and we do like an elf Christmas. We have 35 bags of food to take to them, and we've got 3 bags already, and we're going to be in open 2 weeks. So it's a dropping off point for people as well as the likes of supermarkets and that. So we have a food bank
Good. So it's everything's all community based there, guys. So if anybody wants help, come and see Martin or go to the charity shop. What is the projection room like? Is it a mess or is it?
We have 3 projection rooms in this building. We have obviously 2 smaller ones, and we have the big one upstairs, which is a bit right in the gods. So I did a virtual tour the other week. Never done a virtual tour of the building before. I do tours, but they're few and far between at the moment because of COVID and everything. But we did a tour the other week when my daughter and her friend filmed me on Facebook and Instagram, going around the building, taking people to places that they've never knew occurred, like the back of screen one, where the organ pipes where there's 2 dressing rooms, or they're not dressing rooms now, but they were dressing rooms like Hilda Baker, Arthur Askey, Tommy Trinder, and all those type of people have sat in. And then we do the virtual tour is just a new thing to raise money, but it's something that I'm looking to maybe do a bit more in the future.
So it's something that the project you're working on at the moment.
We have a lot of partnerships with a lot of people. We're lucky that we have partnership with Home and Bargain, Sainsbury's, schools, a lot of schools come in, both primary and senior schools, not only in Sefton but in Merseyside as well, in Liverpool.
Yeah.
You know, they're doing either educational or
it's good.
Or they're doing it's a sort of end of year sort of thing, a treat for the children.
I think it's romantic, to be honest.
Well,
the cinema is like a romantic.
It is because obviously the film there, film's been done there various types over the years. The seats upstairs are the original seats, and obviously the small seats, a bit like the one I'm sitting in now, and the people were petite then, and obviously different now.
Yeah.
Everyone's in different sizes and that. But at the back of the cinema, what we decided to do is put a couple seats in, so we've got two seats. So two people can sit together.
Yeah.
Obviously, with social distancing, a lot of them are taped off under normal circumstances. We've got a couple of seats upstairs, about 16 of them.
I suppose in this sense, a lot of people are probably at the first date here and things like that.
A few people have. We've had a couple in recently. He used to be a volunteer, and he wanted to ask his girlfriend to marry her. So I sorted it out with him, and her birthday was on the 1st of April as well. But there was nothing fool about it.
Yeah.
And he asked us to marry her in screen number 3, and then they watched Singing in the Rain.
That was on Facebook as well. Yeah, that's really lovely.
And then we've done other things for people. You know, we are community based. I don't think the council realise what they've got here, personally, because this is a jewel in the crown, Sefton. And when it's lit up of a night, you can't miss it.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Whereas, the investments in Sefton area are quite poor.
Instead of investing in the things they should invest in,
they
might invest in a lot of things that are just fly-by-night things. Could we have a little tour? Maybe the projection room and anything else you've got?
Yeah, I'll take it into the projection room,
Brilliant.
Park condition. You might be dead by the time you get up here.
Colin has.
Oh, I did. Just take your time then. Slowly.
You're going up where the projection room is. Down the staircase.
Oh god, this is scarily happening. I knew I should have come up here.
Man's just legs is up here.
I can't go back down, I can't go.
Come on, you're here. Come on. Let's go. Take you where you don't normally go.
This is a projector room. That's the old projector.
Yeah.
That's a new one.
It's all digital now, these ones. That's it.
So there's your piece of rabbit here at the moment. This is in the very top of the building.
Yeah.
And the roof is obviously there.
So it does get
old. That's the old projector. Oh, 60 odd years old, that one. Yeah, it gets maintained every week.
That's right, it's in really good condition.
Heart-stopping moments and unforgettable memories.
Big film reels. What's bigger than
you? They went the copper reels with a big steel stainless aluminium spool across.
They're
just ones that we use because there's no room in there to put another big aluminium spool.
Brilliant.
And then there's different rooms.
Yeah.
It's like doors and then where we sell all the equipment in the firing room and we've got
my
we have a mortgage. shop in the workshop and those are already messed. And that's where our chief projectionist goes in there. I was never allowed up here for the first 10 years of my career in here. No one had come up here, no one was allowed to come up here. A bit like being in Royal Mail, really, where you're never allowed to go see the boss. That's just going to sort of like
seeing him. If you had to, you knew something really.
You was in trouble, So obviously, in the old days, you had film reels, and you used to have to film reels up and down the stairs. So there'd be like 8 for the film.
Oh my God.
And you can imagine up and down the stairs every 5 seconds.
Yeah, you'd have to be fit.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Either genocide or anything like that, and then of an evening we show an evening film so the school kids come on the day, and of an evening we do a film and it'd be Schindler's List or something like that. And then the foyer area, we see pictures here of the cinema.
That's 1939.
That was taken. That was the foyer in 1939, and that was inside the screen in 1939. You see the organs there, that was a Compton organ. That went in the 1950s or 60s, but an organ's going back into the screen, which will be a way less an organ.
That's good.
Hide an organ contained in the car park. And then there the prices.
I've seen that.
Yeah, we've seen that,
And then there's something that we wear many years ago, we were a Canon cinema.
So it was
found that about 12 months ago and decided to clean it up and put it up.
Well,
that isn't, that's a couple seat. We purchased that from Stockport. Plaza and Stockport, because we're not affiliated to them, but we visited them and they visited us. It was nice to go and visit them, and their cinema's amazing as well, and it's a theatre as well. So we bought this on eBay. We got it refurbished, and the seats upstairs in that design that's a couple seats, and obviously.
Oh my God, I don't think me and you fit on that column.
You'd be surprised what people can get on it. The floor is the original floor from 1939 as well. This is terrazzo floor. And if you look at the toilets, there's a couple of guys here. There was Chris Skinley, who sadly isn't here anymore. He sadly lost his life due to cancer. He did all the building, all inside, and painted, put a new roof on, did loads of work here. And we're forever indebted to him. And then also Phil Glegg. He just was doing some soundproofing for us, and we said he looks like a good guy, and his professionalism was just amazing, and his workmanship was second to none. And he redid our toilet for us, and he did our ladies' toilet. So if you go into the gents' toilets, and then pass it over to the ladies' toilet,
we'll
show you the standard toilet. You know what I mean? This is something special.
Oh, that's nice, isn't it? All the tiles right there.
All the tiles are the Italian type of tiles.
That's brilliant, isn't it?
And obviously the wrought iron.
The old system?
Yeah. It's called the crapper.
Appropriate name.
And so that one's there in the toilet in screen number one.
Yeah.
We've got an aluminium one, which is amazing. Just amazing. And then obviously these are the original doors. That's not the original, they were put in only a number of years ago. They're the original doors. And outside is the original frontage, which is still the same frontage as well. And then there's the self-bride
picture
we were talking about earlier. And as you can see, the names have been signed upside down, because in those days you folded a poster, whereas now they're rolled and chewed. And that was the first film we showed with the self-bridges in that
Todd.
Yeah, opening nice.
Mr. Chairman. I stand for the fair administration of the limited funds at our disposal. If we give too much here, another will have to go without there.
I take the practical view. I ask myself, is it good business? If it's good business, well, it's right.
What I say is, public affairs are a trust from above. We have dedicated ourselves to the service of the people.
I started life as a socialist. I'm sorry, I'm unrepentant. My ambition is to see the lives of the working masses improved.
And then, as you can see, this is pictures of that. The pod frames, which are those ones there, they're the original ones from 1939. And if you go in there, don't lose anyone in there, are we?
Just to check.
Hello? Hello?
No.
You go in there. And there's the ladies' toilets. Again.
Gorgeous. I did come
the original
in,
floor.
I did come in on Sunday
and
I was
the pictures
really
on the
impressed.
Wall. And then you can see we put some added features on, which are these. And the mirrors, the 1930s mirror.
Yeah, they look amazing. I love the tiles.
And we also trimmed on our toilet with...
I did.
..with the Soroptimists. The Soroptimists who are a women's only charity. And we twinned with the toilet.
Nice.
In Malawi.
Lovely.
We just wanted to do something to prove that we're not just... No, we're not just a cinema, we do everything.
No, we do everything. It's brilliant.
The mirror? Yeah, the
mirror. I've seen that mirror on the way in. I just didn't want to get myself in it. It's brilliant. There's another one in there as well.
Some things we've acquired from other cinemas, other places that would be the closed one. Because the bingo hall is called the Garrick Theatre in Southport, and that's just recently closed as a bingo hall right next to Morrison's. It is.
Oh, yeah.
And that's closed, and now obviously, hopefully, they're going to keep that and restore it and not let the building go to rack and ruin. It is a listed building. Yeah. We're not listed building, they are, so it's amazing inside. We're all at the tables, we're all playing the bingo. This is a small screen, and again, you can see some pictures on the wall.
Yeah.
And then, as you can see, this gives you the effect of when the lights are off, that the ceiling is just not, there's no ceiling there, you know, because it's a black ceiling.
Well,
and this is a 92-seater, obviously it's in blue, it's different to the main screen.
Yeah.
No reference to having an Evertonian, but it is in blue.
Did you pick it?
I don't want to get in blue. Yeah. I've just recently put a ramp in, and we've got the handrails which fell before he passed away. He lost his life as well, it was so horrible. And so we're getting another handrail put here, and there's going to be some decorative thing there. It's got Plaza in Art Deco, established 1939. It's a bit of a surprise to someone.
That'll be really nice. Yeah.
I haven't told her yet. I hope she likes it, but I love it. It looks amazing.
Oh, that'll be lovely.
Mm. Well, make sure she doesn't watch this then, if it's going to be a surprise.
And obviously, the kiosk has changed to what it was. But in 2011, a guy called Kieran Owen came in and said, He wants a team which is together, everyone achieves more.
Yeah.
He wanted to give us a makeover, so he gave us like a challenge, like a makeover.
Oh, yeah.
And that is the catalyst to change from 2011 right through to where we are now.
Yeah.
Obviously, we're in a bit of a rush at the moment, but that was the initiative for the cinema to be a successful cinema.
It's really, really lovely. We'll be coming back to watch. Quiet Place. Is it in that one, is it?
The big one.
Oh, and the big one.
The smaller one. Put the conjuring's going in the smaller one.
It was me thinking I got it right there, I got it wrong.
Do you know, even the we were impressed with the coffee, weren't we?
Yeah, the coffee's
alright. It's right.
Nescafe Gold Blend. It's proper coffee. Not the coffee from the company who gave us a machine.
Yeah.
They didn't want their coffee.
No, but the prices
and the staff
as well.
All do the job, and they're all in the uniform, and they're all in a white shirt.
And the prices are... good as well, not like
the
sweets
are all competitively priced.
Yeah. Not like you go in
the places.
Not like
the places.
Not
at all.
No.
Their prices are way, way too much.
Yeah, anyway, guys, so
make sure
you come and pay this place a visit.
It's really, really lovely. You'll really enjoy it.
Great prices for the films.
It's excellent. It is.
And
they're all doing a brilliant job.
Yeah.
I love it.
All the staff all there. All there. Look, all to attention even. Right, guys, give us
all
a wave.
Drunk.
There you
all drunk. We have to take a tablet before we start the job.
Thanks for that, Martin.
Cheers.
Really
much. I'll see you soon.
Yeah.
I'll be on Sunday watching the film. We might do Sunday as well. We won't be downstairs because there's no seats, I don't think. Well, hopefully there is, because then I can sit upstairs.
Quietly. Watch the step. Okay. Right. Lovely, thank you. Cheers for that. Lovely, thank you. I will do. He said to say hello actually. Yeah. He just sent me a message.
I am still alive.
You're looking well actually.
It's probably because you're keeping that busy, to be honest with you.
Same.
Did you get your name in lights?
I, on my birthday, I try to make sure there's two messages on the canopy so no one puts mine up.
Oh, what a cheat. Okay, then. Let's go. Okay. See you again, man. Thank you. See you. Bye. 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 B